Thank you very much, Mark. In the interest of time, let me also just take this opportunity to congratulate Norfund on its 20th anniversary. Indeed, we are privileged. And I singularly am privileged to be associated with the winners in this space and this combination of wealth of experience in investment. I've mainly been asked to talk about the challenges that face the financial sector in our region, and in South Africa in particular, and as to what it is that is needed in order to address the income disparity that exists through the promotion of inclusive economy. In the first place, I mean, we'll use South Africa as a case study because South Africa itself is not unique in being stuck in a high inequality and low growth trap because of the extreme inequality that you know, dates back in history. As a country, we are grappling also with the lack of the growth that it requires in order to improve living standards, but also to create employment and be able to uplift the community, the population from abject poverty. And this, mainly, this is driven by insufficient job creation, which is exacerbated by the challenging poor standards of living, and of education, actually. And as such, you will find that about a third of our working population is effectively excluded from participating in the mainstream economy. A recent report, which is titled Poverty Trends in South Africa, shows that poverty is on the rise in South Africa. Despite the general decline in poverty between 2006 and 2011, our poverty levels have risen, resulting in more than half of South Africans, which is over 30 million, being poor. As a country also, we are in need of addressing the issue of the, as Eric highlighted, of addressing the issue of the missing middle, the middle class. We need to build this middle class because this is where we are going to be able to begin to change the game in investment. Research, which was initiated by the government's planning, monitoring and evaluation, which is called the National Income Dynamics, indicated that middle class in South Africa is relatively very small. It's about 15%. It has only grown with 2 percentage points in the last 23 years of our democracy. Therefore, if you look at infrastructure bottlenecks, skills mismatches in the workforce, and regulations that stifle competition and entrepreneurship, those are some of the factors that contribute to ensure that a large percentage of the labor force remains outside of the employment circle. What we therefore need now is growth with transformation, which should be inclusive. Transformation without growth, as we all know, could be accompanied by disinvestment, rising unemployment, and less wealth and assets to redistribute. Simply put, without growth, transformation will make us poorer, and without transformation, growth will exacerbate inequality, which will in turn make growth unsustainable in itself. Now, the question of promoting financial inclusion is at the center of our agenda. What is needed now is an approach from government, and that is why the introduction of ARISE, the introduction of the partners that make up ARISE, is a game changer in itself. So it is fundamental that we institute transformational reforms that can boost employment, particularly for young people, reduce inequality, and improve the standard of education, and therefore, over time, promote economic inclusion. And therefore, our institutions need to find ways. As we have seen that there's an over-concentration of financial institutions in South Africa. It is currently dominated by five large banking institutions. And we think with the introduction of this new creative, innovative model, we would be able to crack that and address this the missing middle. There are quite a number of researches also that have been shared with us where, you know, like the one by the World Bank and the United Nations, which show that expanding access to financial products and services has a very strong positive impact on economic development. And the World Bank study, for example, found a strong statistical relationship between financial development and faster growth in income for the poorest quintile of the population. It also found that growth in private credits has a significant negative relationship with income inequality. Therefore, the evidence is very clear. In developing countries like ours and our continent and the region, more finance means more growth and inclusion, and therefore banking needs to be made more accessible to people in Africa to address these income inequalities. Question then is why a company like Arise is important to contribute to the building of an inclusive financial sector that contributes to the establishment of SMEs, job creation, poverty reduction, and economic growth in the sub-Saharan Africa and its countries. One, Arise is committed to investing in strong financial service providers that are operationally sustainable and supports inclusive growth. The second is that Arise has the means to provide much needed stable and long-term capital to banks. Further, Arise can navigate the economic cyclicality and unforeseen systemic shocks, which not only provides certainty to the banks, but also the country's regulators. Arise also is active on the ground, as we have seen since January this year. Their in-house team with expertise on credit risk, corporate governance, IT and agri-finance, retail banking, can contribute to the bank's competence building strategies. It aims to empower banks so that they can improve their services to their clients. Therefore, an increase in investment leads to an increase in economic growth and contributes to job creation and social upliftment. Therefore, we expect Arise to play a pivotal role in making banking more accessible to our people. And as I've said, it is this partnership that we think is indeed going to change the complexion of investment in the region. As I've said, we use South Africa because that's where we have our experience, but we're talking the region, we're talking the continent, and it is this partnership that we think is going to make a huge difference going forward. Thank you very much.